paper that people might want to see. Yeah. Seems to hide out.
But Francis has never told Jay this.
No.
Well, now we come to the party. Yes. And the invitation and the fact they're bringing all of their children with them.
Yes.
And who should be there but this, now he's white-haired, he's put on some weight, he's working for Vic.
Yes, he is.
And yes, Rich says, Francis, and my wife, Carmen, and it's such a shock to her.
It is, of course, because she's actually, oddly enough, thought of him earlier for the first time in years because the name O'Sullivan comes up in a conversation with her husband, but she doesn't think much else of it. And then when she encounters him, it's her past slapping her in the face, the past that she has tried so hard to cover up and never reveal to anyone, because Frances is the person who doesn't like to reveal things. She likes to pretend everything is okay, yeah, including with her daughter, including with her finances, yeah, including with her marriage. Everything is, you put on a face, you act like it's perfect.
You do bring up something that I hadn't been aware of, the bigotry that Indians coming to America will often face because they are not totally, supposedly, Caucasian.
Oh, you mean that the Indians themselves, like,
yeah,
like I would face?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, I mean, because you can face bigotry anywhere, right?
Yeah.
You could face bigotry because you're too fat, you're too short, you're the wrong color. And so, absolutely, yeah, you do. I faced it in this country.
Uh-huh. How did it manifest itself?
For me?
Yeah.
Are you prepared to be shocked?
Sure.
I actually faced it when I was a graduate student at Berkeley. I was in the graduate program in journalism, and I had a professor who just despised me, and he once locked the door. He wouldn't let me in the class, and then he would always call on me in the classroom and give me the hardest time. And this is when he finally revealed himself to me. You know, you have those conferences with your students. And mm-hmm. So he called me in, and this was in journalism, so you're writing articles, and you'd have to write two articles a week. And he was telling me how wrong my article was and picking it apart, which is fine. You're supposed to learn,
yeah,
from a professor. But I still remember, I'll never forget, he was obsessed with the usage of the word, a word that I had used, and absconded actually was the word. And he kept telling me I hadn't used it correctly. And so finally, I was so tired, I said, you know, I must have used it as Indian English, because it is something called Indian English.
Yeah.
And so he looked at me and he said, I'm going to look it in the dictionary. And so he opened it up, and sure enough, my usage was correct.
Yeah.
He looks at me and he says, I don't trust this dictionary. I'm going to go to the Oxford English one. He slams it shut, and he looks at me and he says, you know, we have the Indian Consul General lives in San Francisco. His daughter was at Berkeley a few years ago, and she never made it. I suggest you just drop out right now. You're not cut out to make it. And so, you know what I did, Connie?
I hope you reported him, is what I hope. Yeah.
You know, I tried to, believe it or not, because it becomes a huge issue then. I didn't. It's sort of like, do you really want to take someone to court?
Yeah.
You have to be prepared to do that. So what I did instead was, I did my degree in a year and a half, Connie. Most people,
yeah,
take 2 years.
Yeah.
So I showed him an Indian could do it with one hand tied behind her back.
Have you ever, I mean, something like that eats at you. Have you gone back to Berkeley, or have you followed what happened to him?
To him? I didn't. But here's another story. When I was looking for an agent, you call up,
yeah,
people, and so they'll ask you, what have you done? And so I said, I did a degree in journalism,
yeah,
from Berkeley, along with Complete, mind you. I loved my Complete program. I loved it. And so when I was talking to this particular agent who lives in the Napa Valley area, she said, my husband taught there. And I said, really? Who would he be? So she named him.
Yeah.
And I said, you know what? I'm afraid I can't even talk to you. I said, I'm going to hang up because I have no interest in having you represent me.
Yeah.
So she said, you've got to tell me why. So I told her. And then I ended the conversation by telling her, I said, I'm sure he's a nice guy, but, people in prisons in San Quentin, I'm sure somebody loves them too,
Yeah.
So you can love him, but I want to have nothing to do with someone associated with him.
Bravo.
So,
bravo.
So,
I would have thought you might have used him as a character in a book.
I don't like to use people I don't like. in that sense. I just think there was something very flawed about him. And my friend saw what he was doing to me.
Yeah.
It was known to the people. And I, you know, so no, I don't want to give him any
How
space in my writing.
How different was Berkeley from going to college in India?
Oh, wow, night and day doesn't say the answer correctly. For one thing, I was amazed that Berkeley, the campus didn't have a wall around it.
Yeah.
All Indian colleges I went to had walls around them.
Really?
So yeah, to keep all the bad guys out.
Yeah.
And they were for girls, I mean, it was a girls' institution. So the fact that I could pick my classes, that I could take fencing, which is what I did. I took up tennis. I did a lot of stuff I couldn't do normally.
Mm-hmm.
It was wonderful. I grew a lot then. I think that's when I learned to write, because I also got a job teaching at Berkeley.
Yeah.
So when you teach writing, I think you learn how to write.
Meanwhile, at the party, our friend Rajesh takes ill, and Jonathan had recognized it but didn't do anything about it. And then when Rajesh collapses and Jonathan recognizes it, suddenly all the Indian doctors, because that's again a profession they, you know, you do to tell your mother back home, cut him out. He's literally pushed aside.
I like that scene because it, as Lali says over there, it was the first time he was pushed aside.
Yeah.
Because normally it is the Indian who might be pushed aside, who feels like the outsider in this country now and then, not always.
Yeah.
I don't want anyone to feel that America is not an inclusive country. It certainly is. But Lali has felt estranged, and she had that feeling and experienced it on the way over when she was going through, you know, when she was putting a boarding pass and all the whatever those things are that go off because she had metal studs on her jacket, and she felt the estrangement of being an Indian. And she looks and she, and it allows her to be closer to Jonathan because he's experienced what she has.
Yeah, it's interesting. My ignorance about not having it happen, so until you have lived through it, you hear it, but it doesn't hit you. I will say that I have lived in foreign countries where I didn't speak the language.
Mm-hmm.
And if you don't speak language, the only thing you can do is really clean a house. The absolute elementary things about life.
Right. I wouldn't say that you're ignorant. I'm happy that you haven't experienced it.
Yeah.
It's not a pleasant thing.
No, it isn't.
It really isn't.
One does in other ways, but not that way.
No.
And I was surprised. It just surprised me that they would pick on Lali because she had buttons on her blouse.
Well, yes. And of course, the buttons represent the fact that she had bought that blouse to meet the guy she had gone out with before.
Yes.
So I like the fact that
it
was all these reasons for her not to meet Akash. Yeah. But
I love the book. As you can tell, I have really read it and digested. And I will look forward to telling people about it. And there's got to be another story behind this one.
Oh, you mean after this one?
Yes.
Yes, I'm actually working on another novel right now.
Good.
Yes.
I kept thinking that possibly Nikki and Mandy might have a future, but one never knows.
Oh, you're such a romantic.
Will you autograph my book?
Yes,
and
I'd love to.
And if you'd like to know what else we've been reading, visit me on the web at www.ConnieMartinson.com. You can read our columns from the Beverly Hills Courier. You can link in to Claremont Graduate University's Digital Library. But whatever you do, support your local library, because libraries need all the help they can get, especially in these economic times. Because despite the computer, despite the internet, there is something about holding that book in your hand, taking it out of the library. And we'll see you next time. Thank you so very much, Anne.
Thank you for this invitation.